When it comes to screening employment applications, how long is your applicant status code list? Especially if you're subject to compliance reporting, the list can get very long and specific. For example, noting the exact reasons why each candidate fails to meet minimum basic qualifications, experience, education, etc. And while you would want that level of detail for your internal status assignments, you wouldn't need to share that with candidates externally. What if you could introduce a self-service component that allows applicants to log into their profile and check on the status of their own job application? Well, you can. And the best part, you get to choose the public-facing label for each of your internal status codes. So what you know is not selected slash basic qualifications slash experience would simply show up as not selected to the candidate externally. And think about the positive application of that feature. For what you use as sent to hiring manager internally, you could more strategically rename that status code screened by HR slash sent to hiring manager to serve as a positive reinforcement to candidates that would otherwise disengage without prompt feedback about their employment application. This tool can be a competitive advantage in this age of immediate feedback, as long as you screen your applications promptly. If you're interested in turning on this feature, the ExactHire Client Services team would love to help you. Please email them at support@exacthire.com. Once enabled, admin users will see a new field when adding or editing status codes called Status Shown to Applicants. Likewise, candidates, once they've logged into their HireCentric profile, will see a public-facing version of your internal status codes assigned to them. Thanks, and have a great day.